Today, I'm going to give you some tips on how to get rid of your unnecessary filler words. We're going to look at Ovation's virtual reality software that integrates AI as one powerful tool to help you do it. Ovation sponsored this video. I almost never partner with sponsors, but this is a powerful public speaking tool, and I think you're going to want to hear about it. And of course, I'm going to give you an honest look at all the pros and overall cons of this as well. I'm not going to give you an entire tour of this software today, but Ovation is a comprehensive way to practice and improve your public speaking in a fun and dynamic way. It's a really powerful program based upon my familiarity with it so far. And I'll put links to Ovation's website in the description below this video so you can take a look at that as soon as you're motivated. We'll look at other aspects of this in future videos. Right now, we're going to skip over a lot and show you how you can use this to reduce your own filler words, which is a stubborn issue for many public speakers, but one that Ovation will help you excel at. For example, Ovation has a question and answer feature, so you don't have to practice with a prepared speech if you don't have one ready. The software is preloaded with hundreds of questions that you can use as a jumping off place to do a short practice speech. Earlier, I recorded a mini speech with the headset, and the question I responded to was, "What was your happiest childhood memory?" I wasn't trying to be perfect or inspirational. I didn't want to practice this or write any notes beforehand. I just hit record. I treated this like an impromptu practice exercise to work on fillers. I read the prompt, I thought about what I wanted to say, took a deep breath, and talked for a minute or so. And what you'll see is take one, so keep that in mind as you watch it. Here's what it looks like when you enter a speaking venue wearing the headset. If I were practicing a prepared speech, I would have uploaded my slides or notes to those confidence monitors on the floor. Let's change the view so you're looking at me and it won't look as shaky on playback. And be on the lookout for any filler words as I answer this question. Many years ago, from age 5 to about 10, every summer I would get in the car and travel to Horseneck Beach in Massachusetts with my mom, dad, and two brothers. These summers at Horseneck Beach camping are really my favorite childhood memory. There are three reasons I loved camping so much every summer. And the first one is obviously the beach. Every day we would wake up in the morning, we would head over the dunes, swim all day, boogie board, build sandcastles. The beach is an incredibly fond memory for me. The second thing I loved most about this is that I got to spend time with not just my mom, dad, brothers, but we also hung out with my cousins, my aunts, my uncles. It was like a week-long family reunion every single summer for about 5 years straight. And the third best part about this memory are the sand dunes behind the beach on the other side of the campground. Every night after we had our campfire and marshmallows, we would head up into the sand dunes and play hide and seek for hours. There's lots of mysteries in between those bushes and trees and dunes, and we explored every single night to our heart's delight. And those are the three reasons that camping at Horseneck Beach every summer is my favorite childhood memory. That's how it came out. We're going to talk about how to get rid of fillers in a minute, but keep in mind, if you're not familiar with virtual reality yet, nobody is going to see you inside the software like that unless you invite them in like you would for an online video game. It's a really private but realistic way to practice, and it offers a lot of help. Now, how can you stop using filler words, and how can Ovation help you do that? My number one tip is that you have to recognize that you're using filler words in the first place. Many people don't realize they're using filler words unless somebody tells them. Ovation helps raise your awareness of your fillers immediately. Anytime you use a filler, a notification almost instantly pops up on the screen in real time. That instant feedback is priceless. Without Ovation, you'd have to do it the old-fashioned way, like record your speech on your phone and listen for your fillers later. A tip I often give speakers is to identify your top two or three fillers and work on eliminating those first. Immediately after your speech, you can look at an analysis of how you did. You can look at your eye contact, hand gestures, lots of other variables. Right now, we're looking at my voice. The analysis says I had a comfortable speaking rate. I avoided most fillers. They scored me at 100%, but some fillers did pop up while I was doing the speech. I believe Ovation is giving me 100% because most of the fillers they're counting were real words, or because my filler rate was so low per minute. I said really, so, just, and the word like. You'll notice I only used each of those words once, but if you use a word repetitively, Ovation will show you which fillers you're struggling with the most. Now, the fillers I use may not sound like typical filler words to you, so let's talk more about that. The software catches filler words you may not realize are fillers, at least some of the time. Overall, I find this to be helpful. Most beginner listeners and speakers only focus on the most obvious filler words, you know, like, and a few others. But the truth is, many speakers use lots of extra words that don't belong. At one point, I used the word really, and Ovation identified that as a filler. Not everybody would consider that a typical public speaking filler word, but when I look at how I used it in my speech, it didn't need to be there. It was an extra word that added clutter. In another instance, I used the word so, as in so much, and that popped up as a filler. Now, saying so much is a legitimate use of the word so, but the software is on the lookout for the word so because it's often used as a transitional filler word between thoughts or sentences. Because I used it appropriately, I just ignore that instance of feedback. The point is, Ovation is an extremely helpful tool for identifying your top filler words and even bring to your attention words that you don't realize are filler words in the first place. The software also tracks your filler rate with a fillers per minute score, and this is where it can get a little fun. Overall, I use 2.7 filler words per minute. Based upon my experience with this so far and what I've heard from the people at Ovation, a reasonable goal for a beginner is aim for 10 filler words or less per minute. And then ultimately, you want to strive for fewer than 5 fillers per minute. If you can reach 5 fillers per minute or fewer, that's just normal human speech. Most listeners won't even notice your filler words at that point. Tip number one is to identify your filler words, and I doubt any human being can do that as well as Ovation. But what do you do next? Tip number two is to pause silently instead of using a filler word. One of the things I love about Ovation is that it allows for extended pauses before it asks you if you're ending your speech. The reason I love this is that if you were in front of real people, you'd be tempted to fill that silence with a filler word. But in a simulator like this, you can take a nice long pause, take a breath, without feeling self-conscious, because you know these aren't real listeners. And that'll help you get more comfortable with silence overall and work against the temptation to put fillers in where silent pauses should go. I've mentioned this in other videos, but my go-to filler words used to be sort of, and kind of. Now, here's a technique I use to get rid of them. Anytime you're about to catch yourself saying a filler word or you say one, replace it with the word pause or period. You may want to say this aloud at first, but in time, progress so you can say pause or period in your head instead of saying the filler aloud. Pause and don't speak until you know the next word you want to say. And you'll notice I paused numerous times in the sample speech. In real life, your listeners will hear that silence as a thoughtful pause. Then a pause always sounds better than a filler. Tip number three is to practice until you create a new habit that embraces the power of the pause. Ovation is an excellent practice tool. When my students and clients practice their presentations in real life, just a few more repetitions, they tend to use fewer filler words, even when they're not actively trying to reduce those, because those practice sessions prepare them in a way that they're not searching for the right words during the speech. But what if you're not currently working on a specific presentation? What if you use filler words in everyday conversation? You want to get rid of that. Ovation has a question and answer feature, like the one I did for my sample speech, that'll give you lots of repetitions in a fairly fun way. Ovation has hundreds of preloaded questions and prompts, and you can use each question as an opportunity to do a mini impromptu speech. You could, for example, answer 5 questions in a row and make it your goal to reduce your fillers with each repetition. One of the features that we'll be talking about in future videos is the way Ovation uses AI to analyze whatever speech or answer you give and then ask follow-up questions about the exact content you just spoke about. Audience members in the room will actually stand up one at a time and ask you legitimate and interesting questions about your speech content. Each follow-up question is another opportunity to practice your public speaking. And all that practice is a fantastic way to replace your old habits like fillers with good habits like powerful pauses. Let's look at the overall pros and cons of Ovation. We'll start with the downsides. First, if you don't already own a virtual reality headset like this Quest 3, then you can't access some of Ovation's features that are only on the headset version. Now, Ovation does offer a desktop or laptop version. Many people or families already own one of those, but as of this video, that's only on PCs. I've been told that a Mac version is coming maybe near the end of 2024 or the beginning of 2025, but it's not out as of this video. Again, I encourage you to look at the link to Ovation's website for updates on that. Second, there are downsides that come with any new software or virtual reality game, and Ovation is no exception. It takes time to learn and get comfortable with this stuff. I spent the first 15 minutes on the laptop version getting familiar with the options before I felt ready to practice. The headset version has many more features, and it really does feel like you're in the room with people. But the point is, if this is your first experience using virtual reality, it's a pretty steep learning curve to get comfortable because of all those extra features, options, and using the controllers. So you have to be patient with yourself as you get comfortable with the technology. The third downside, using Ovation for the first time is not a good option if you have to give your speech tomorrow. Don't look at this as a quick fix. Ovation is a much better option if you're going to be working on speeches and practicing over the course of a week or more. That'll give you time to learn how Ovation works first and then get the benefits of practicing with it to improve your communication. Of course, once you're familiar with the software, you could use this on a daily basis. Let's look at some of the advantages aside from what I've already mentioned. Ovation does a lot more than help you reduce your fillers. The software is a comprehensive tool to improve your communication. You can work on how you communicate in meetings, during interviews, and in one-on-one conversations. You can use it to practice with your notes or with your PowerPoint slides on the monitors. You can even use it to work on your eye contact and hand gestures when you're using the headset. It's a total package. Ovation gives you a no-pressure, interesting way to practice. If you make mistakes, who cares? It's immersive, but the people and AI aren't judging you the way real people might. It's a great alternative if you have a tendency toward perfectionism, anxiety, or feeling judged. I didn't feel any of that while using Ovation because there's no negative consequences for making mistakes. In the same way, it has a playful feeling. Once I became comfortable with the headset and got used to what buttons to push, I started to enjoy it. It's like a game in that it has a playful dynamic and it rewards you for doing well. It's also realistic enough to motivate me to want to improve. The analytical features, the scores, the grades, made me want to see those scores get better. There's a little gamification in it, but it tracks everything with a lot of precision, which I really appreciate. It has lots of options and customizable settings. I'm just going to scratch the surface here, but it has different types and sizes of rooms. You can adjust how crowded the room is. You can customize your avatar. There's a pure presentation mode or a presentation plus Q&A after that. You can even adjust the difficulty level of the questions so the people in the room ask you neutral, difficult, or even confrontational questions, which was a fun way for me to practice putting myself under pressure. If you're wearing the headset, you can hold the virtual reality speaking notes in your hand, or hold a tablet of your notes, or put your notes on a teleprompter or on the monitor on the floor. You can preload it with specific questions to ask you for interviewing purposes. This video is mainly about fillers, but I'm going to do follow-up videos about this because there are too many helpful options in Ovation to cover it all now. There's also a whole nother level of depth of analysis we didn't even get into in this video. There's an analytical AI feature of the software that can track variables like authenticity, coherence, structure, conciseness, emotion. I didn't even know this was possible. You can ask it to analyze dozens of other variables about the speech content itself. As mentioned, you can take a closer look at Ovation by visiting their website. There's a link in the expandable description below. Big picture, I hope this video motivated you and gave you some tips on how to get rid of your fillers and introduce you to a powerful tool to help you improve your public speaking overall. Until next time, thanks, God bless, and I'll see you soon.